The sky is dark and the lights are on. Welcome to qualifying here at the Marina Bay Street Circuit in Singapore. And as we wait, poised for the start of what will hopefully be a thrilling qualifying, why don't you tell us, Anthony Davidson, about the things you can do to really get the most out of a car in a session like this?
Well, you're largely limited by the Parc Fermé regulations, of course. Back in the old days, pre-2004, you'd work on both a qualifying setup and a race setup over practice, and then swap them over after qualifying. So the race car was quite different at times to the qualifying car. Nowadays, though, you have to find a compromise that works for both. There are a few things that you can still adjust during the session, such as the differential, the brake bias, and the front wing angle, but that's about it. So it's more about optimizing what you do have and adapting your own style to suit the track conditions.
Don't think you'll have any trouble getting into the next session, so don't push too hard. Right, I'll get these changes made. may remember that the way the car handles is all about weight transfer. When you break the center of mass...
It looks like it could be a tense round of the championship here as we prepare to get today's race underway. Situated just 88 miles north of the equator, this 3.5 mile circuit is hot, it's humid, and is an incredible test for the drivers as they try to fight their cars around the bumps and in between the barriers. 23 corners take us twice over the bay to complete a single lap of this unique racetrack. The view is spectacular, the heat is unbearable. The race should be incredible. I'm joined again today by none other than Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, obviously there's a lot of development work that goes on with these cars between the races. You've been both a test driver and a race driver. What differences are there in the way you approach those roles?
Interesting question, Crofty. They're two very different mindsets. I mean, when I tested for BAR, we had full in-season testing where, per driver, you'd cover up to 15,000 kilometres per season. And in that role, it was more about working for the team, trying to help them improve the car and drive as systematically as you could, so that that data could be analysed in the most consistent way. When you're lining up on the grid for a race, however, your frame of mind's all about what you can get out of the situation on that day. And the car's the tool to help you achieve what you want. You still want to focus on setup, of course, but it's more about the here and now, getting yourself as far up the field as possible, and less about development work for the future.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. Valtteri Bottas lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Verstappen, Daniel Ricciardo, and Perez, Ocon, Sainz, Grosjean, and Daniel Kvyat, Alonso, Hülkenberg, Felipe Massa, and Magnussen, Van Dorn, Stroll, Jolyon Palmer, and Pascal Wehrlein, Ericsson, and Sebastian Vettel starts from the back of the grid. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Okay, here we go. I know what you can do. Don't let me down. Thank you. are good. We need to stay in formation and start bringing the car up to temperature, please. Get some load into the tyres and work the brakes. We want them nice and warm by the end of the lap. try shifting up the gears a little sooner, this should help us save some fuel.
Distance to teammate 14.
is 1.9 seconds. Thank you. bit more fuel. strategy, your pit window opens in 15 laps time.
Was 1:45.4.
2.1 seconds. penalty. Slow your pace immediately. Pitting this lap then. Come into the pits at the end of this lap. 4.2 seconds. Safety car is ending. Maintain your pace until the green flag. VSC ending. Wait for green. Okay, clear. So, the gap to our teammate is 42.2 seconds. Thank you. is lapping faster than us by around 1 second per lap. he's just put in the fastest lap of the race. get some information on Ricardo. They are out of the race.
Thank you.
this is your final lap of the race.
That's a fantastic performance from Ferrari. It hardly looked in doubt. Fantastic win for Ferrari. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. It's a good result for Sebastian Vettel, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
I'm going to go for Sebastian Vettel. People have suggested before that he can't race wheel to wheel, but as he showed today, it's nonsense.
On to the constructors then. Ferrari extend their lead at the top of the championship. Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling installment of this Formula One season.